In this video, I would like to talk a bit about shapefiles and the data that comes with geographic vector informations, so these additional data that make a GIS useful, and the possibilities to see this data, look through this data, and how we can work with this data will be the topic of another video. So, most of the vector data that we will use currently come in the form of a shapefile. Shapefiles are quite an older format already. Originally they were introduced by ESRI, so that's why it's still called ESRI shapefile. But currently they are more or less the standard how to exchange spatial data. This might change in the near future because there are other competitors out there that have certain benefits over the shapefiles, but on the time being, this is still the standard file format. So shapefiles are a basic file structure for storing map elements. They store spatial data like points, lines, and polygons, and multiple files actually comprise a shapefile. So a shapefile is a set of different files that are all named the same but have different extensions. This is the example from the source material I used. I will show you a live example with our shapefile. So here is my download folder. Here is the points data that we already used and that we just imported as zip into QGIS. If we extract that and look into the structure here, we can see that this shapefile actually consists of different files. So this points.shp is the actual shapefile. And this holds the geometry, so the geographic information, the coordinates, to put it blankly. Accompanied with that, there is a DBF file. That is a file in the DBase file format, a quite antique database file format that is used here to store the additional information that comes with the geographic information. Then we need, there is also this PRG file that specifies the projection in which the coordinates come. We will see later that there are different projection systems and geographic reference systems, and which of them is used to describe the points in our dataset is stored here in the projection file. Then we have this shx file, that's an index file that makes the processing of the geographic information faster. And then you also might see something like that. That's the a file that stores the information about the encoding of the data, the character encoding. So different countries have different character encodings, and also different operation systems use different ones. Nowadays, the standard is Unicode, but Windows machines, for example, store their files most often also in other encodings. So that's why this file is optional, specifying what kind of character encoding is used. These four together are always represented in a shapefile. So browsing shortly over the presentation here. So the shape is the main file, then we have the dbase file, then we have the projection file and the index file. And we also might see this character identifying file, CPG. And there are other options of spatial index files for features that might also occur. Shapefiles, as it is an old format, have few limitations. One of them is that you only can store one geometry type, so either points, lines, or polygons per shapefile, which can result in, if you have different geometries for your data, can result in a situation where you have for every geometry to produce an own shapefile, and as they already consists of four files, you can end up with quite a file list. That's one of the things that is handled better in other file formats. Okay, So let's have a look at our shapefile here, the point file. As I said, beside the geographic information that are already represented here in the fact that we can map this information, there are more information available to that. And we use that already for making these labels here. To access this additional information, you can either use this identify button here and click on one of the objects, and then you will see here small window that gives you an overview over the attributes of the specific object. If I click to another one here, I can see that this changes here, so there are other options saved here, or other information saved to the other spatial object here. If we want to see all of them at once, we have to open the attribute table, and that can be done by right-clicking on the layer and selecting attribute table here. And here is this attribute table for our objects. There are few, so we have only 5 objects here. Every row represents one of the spatial objects, one of the points. And then we have columns here specifying the information here. So in this file set, in this point set, we have only the NID, a consecutive number in this case, and a label that we use already to label these informations. Let's add another shapefile, and then we'll see a more complex structure. So I add another shapefile by using layer, add layer, vector layer, and select here this going out in Bern file set, shape file collection. If I add that and close that, we can now see here are multiple other dots on the map now. And if I again open the attribute table here, you can see that this data set consists of much more information about different restaurants, bars, and cafes in Bern. So you can see here that there are multiple columns. Most of them have this null value, so there is no value stored in that. But you also can see that you can store very many information that are combined with the geographic information. And how we can work with this information, we will see in a later video. Okay, so the attribute table can be opened by right-click on the layer, and then I forgot that. You have also the option to switch between table view, that's what we currently have open here, and form view. And in the form view, we see the individual objects here, and then all the information for these objects in such a kind of a form, which might be useful for entering the data to the individual objects if you want to edit the data, because this might be more convenient for you. Or if you open up attribute table and you are confronted with that, now you know that you can click here and come back to this table view. Okay, so shapefiles and attribute tables. Since shapefiles are an antique file format, there are also some limitations to the attributes that you can save with a shapefile, more specifically to the names. So the column names in a shapefile can only be letters, numbers, or underscores. No spaces are allowed, for example. And the column names can only be 10 characters long. So that's the limitation that we have here. Okay. In the presentation to this course, you will find this slide here. There's the download link. And if you watch the video, the source for these presentations is shown in the video. So you can check out this presentation and work with that on your own. Okay, that's enough for this video. And in the next video, we will see more what we can do with this data that comes with your geographic informations.